Rocco, I'm number 20. I'm a junior and I'm a guard.
Alexa Holland, junior guard, number 10.
Ali Larkin, junior guard, number 30.
Bailey Abbott, senior forward, number 24.
Hi, I'm Keaton Stasia. I'm a junior and I'm a forward, number 12.
Grace Pfeiffer, freshman guard, number 14.
Alexis Elliott, freshman guard, number 22.
Kennedy Moseman, freshman center, 44.
Morgan Ruff, freshman guard, number 32.
I'm Alexa Garrison, number 40, and a sophomore forward.
Emma Dahlquist, freshman center, number 54.
Guard will be a 5'3 senior, Claire Cromer. The second guard will be a 5'6 guard, Kristen Cromer. The third guard will be a 5'6 senior, Shelby Stone. At one forward, a 5'9 junior, Sydney Mullen. And the other forward will be a 5'9 senior, I'm sorry, a 5'10 senior, Sarah Puckett. And Rochester Coast, Mr. Matt Stone. For the Rochester Lady Zebras, they are 9-0 and 1-0 in the TRC. At one guard will be a 5'2 junior, Alexa Holland. The second guard, 5'4 junior, Becky Malko. The third guard, 5'6 junior, Allie Larkin. At one forward, 5'3 junior, Keaton Stasiak. And the second forward will be a 5'6 senior, Bailey Abbott. Rochester Coast for Mr. Tony Stasiak. This is the game. One of the few games Rochester actually has circled on their schedule. Twin Lakes is one of them.
Yeah.
Culver's one of them. And now you've got Wabash, and the next one I believe is going to be Triton
on Wednesday night. Yeah.
Wabash has had their way with Rochester for 8 years.
Yeah, you're right, and that's why they're circled. And
yeah.
You know, if you can get a win against this team, you know, Rochester only lost 5 games last year, all season long, and this was one of them.
And Triton was one of them.
And yeah, Triton was one of them. So, you know, these next 2 games is where you start to turn around that from, you know, going 17-5 last year to doing better this year.
The Rochester Lady Zebras and their home whites, the Wabash Lady Apaches and their road blacks. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. In the JV contest tonight went to Wabash over Rochester, 46-36. Kennedy Musselman at 18 points and 7 rips in that game. She only played the first half. JV now 7-2.
Pretty good numbers.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah.
And I'll cut her workout tonight when we get home to down to an hour instead of 2 hours. So the ball is up and the tip controlled by the Wabash Lady Apaches. Stone runs the point. Works left side. Now down low to Puckett. Puckett over Stasiak. Shot blocked. Keaton picks up the rebound. Keaton runs it up the floor. Keaton high on the right side. Gives middle of the floor to Holland. Now left side to Malko. Malko runs the paint. Down low to Bailey Abbott. Her layup is off the glass and good.
Nice job by Abbott. Great job by Malko on the look.
Claire Cromer now has the basketball. Rochester in a 2-1-2 trap. Now to Stone over the top of the defense. Stone splits the double team. Down low to Puckett. Puckett on the block. Didn't even look for a shot.
Gave up a shot, yeah.
Outside to Kristen Cromer. Leaner off the glass is good. We're tied at 2. Yeah, she was wide open on the block and didn't even look at it for a shot. 2-2 here at Rochester High School. Lady Zebras with the basketball going to our left. Holland high on the left side against Claire Cromer in the man-to-man defense. Holland, top of the key, now to Larkin. Larkin, crossover dribble, goes to the paint, cut off by the defense, outside to Malko. She'll fire a 3 from left wing. It's good!
Well, that's going to be the key for Rochester tonight. They're going to have to shoot well. They're going to have to move the basketball. They can't get caught standing and waiting.
2-2-1. Kristen Cromer in the left corner gets a double team. Got to get rid of it. Got to get rid of it over the top of the defense to Mullen. Her jumper is short. Rebound by Mullet for Wabash, and she gives the Stone. Now left side to Puckett, looks at a 3, passes it up, drives in the elbow. Now to go to the paint, the follow-away jumper over Stasiak's no good. Keaton rips and runs.
I think that's going to be another key for Rochester's, limiting the look that Wabash gives.
Malko down low to Bailey Abbott. Abbott kicks it out to Holland. X in the corner, inside the arc. The shot on the way is good, off the rafters and through.
That was a tough shot by Holland, and it's a good sign when things like that start to go.
7-2 Rochester, 6-10 to play in the first quarter. Stone to Claire Cromer over the top of Kristen Cromer in the corner now to Mullet. Mullet, one dribble. Back in the corner to Puckett against the double team. Over the top to Stone. Outside you, Claire Cromer, wide open 3, right wing is good.
And you cannot leave her open.
Yep. 7-5 Rochester, 5:50 to play in the first quarter.
The defense, Holland, got sucked into the paint, and the pass went over the top to Cromer. You can't allow that to happen.
Malko picks away through the defense, gives it wide over Bailey Abbott. Shot good, and a foul. Great pass, great look by Malco. Good finish by Abbott. She's got a chance to go to the line to complete the three-point play. Rochester up by four with 5:43 to play in the first quarter.
And the foul was called on Cromer.
Which one? Claire, yeah. 10-5 Rochester. Bailey Abbott makes the free throw, and Rochester up by five. And, yeah, if you're going to pick up fouls for Rochester, or for Wahlbach, I should say, you want that to go on number four. Claire Cromer against a double team, and she travels. Good defense by Alexa Holland.
First turnover. Lady Patsy's not getting off to a good start.
5.5 to play the first quarter. Rochester by five at 10-5. It'll be their basketball right in front of the scores table going to our left.
But boy, defensively, if they can limit Wahlbach to one shot and done, that takes away opportunities for Cromer to get a good look.
Abbott, left side to Holland. X behind the three-point line. Jumper over Claire Cromer is short. Rebound fall four. Wahlbach comes out of the wizard. Mullet with the basketball. And has it kicked out of bounds by Stasiak. And Wahlbach will keep it right in front of the student section.
That shot by Holland was the first one they've missed in this game.
Wow. That's not bad.
No.
And they're up 10-5.
Yep.
10:15 to play in the first quarter. Rochester, what are they in, a 1-3-1?
I wouldn't be surprised if I run the box on Cromer.
Kristen Cromer drives to the basket, and she is fouled by Allie Larkin on the shot that's going to send Kristen Cromer to the line to shoot two. What do you think?
I wouldn't be surprised if they aren't playing a box and one.
I would agree with that as well.
I mean, you're not going to stop Cromer, but you can definitely make it tougher for her.
Yeah. Kristen Cromer's first free throw. Nope. One more coming for Wahlbach.
This is the little sister of Claire.
And she'll have one more.
Little sister, she's actually, what, 2 inches taller?
Second one, no good again. Good block out by Stasiak. Holland clears the board. Holland high on the right side for Rochester. Hesitates, accelerates, kicks it out to Stasiak. Stasiak runs it right. Outside to Malco. She'll fire a three from the right wing. Off the mark, no good. Rebound, ball four. Puckett comes out of there with it. Boy, Bailey Abbott just about picked up foul number two.
She's got to be careful. She's got to get in front of that for the rebound.
Claire Cromer high on the right side. 1-3-1 zone by the Lady Zebras. Stone. Left wing, bounce pass to Puckett in the corner. Puckett over the top of the defense to Claire Cromer. Claire Cromer between the rings, works right side, one dribble to Puckett. Puckett in the lane, leaner on the way, is no good off the mark. Bailey Abbott rips the board. Outlet to Malco. Malco on the left side. Now the free throw line, outside to Stasiak. Keaton, bounce pass to Larkin, wide open three, right wing for the Lady Zebras is off the mark, no good.
Looks good.
Claire Cromer grabs the board and runs.
Look
Cromer. Yeah.
Looked good until it hit iron.
Puckett in the right corner. Over the top of the defense to Stone. Down low to Kristen Cromer. She is fouled by Bailey Abbott. That'll be two on Abbott. And that's going to send Kristen Cromer back in the lane to shoot two. Who do you go to here? Your post player's got two. Is it Ruff? Is it Garrison? Is it Odell?
Well, I have Abbott as one.
Oh, who's the first one?
The first one was on Larkin.
Oh, yeah, I'm apparently watching a different game.
All right.
First one for Kristen Cromer is no good. She's 0-3.
Yes. Yes.
Into the game for the first time is Sarah Ritter, and coming out is Mullet for the Wahlbach Lady Apaches. One more coming for Kristen Cromer. Rochester up 10-5. We've been at the score for a minute and a half at least. Second one for Kristen Cromer is good, and she'll come out. And into the game for the first time is Madison Barton. 10-6 Rochester.
They need to just keep pushing, as these Lady Zebras do. They're doing a good job of working the ball around the point and finding an open shooter.
Man-to-man defense by Wahlbach. Holland fakes a three to Larkin. Larkin in the paint. Puts the defense and throws the ball right into the hands of Puckett. Puckett then picks it up and gives to Stone. Stone across the timeline. Back to Puckett high on the right side and travels. 3:46 to play, first half, Rochester by four.
Well, I think offensively for the Lady Zebras, Holland, Malco, and Larkin have to work in conjunction together and just keep that ball moving at the point until they can find one of the three or one of the two down low for an open shot.
Bailey Abbott's got 4 points and had three great look down low. Layup by Bailey Malco is no good. And Puckett grabs the rebound and gives to Stone. Stone middle of the floor. To Claire Cromer, back to Stone, now left side to Ritter. Ritter in the corner to Barton. Wow. Barton outside for Claire Cromer, just barely draws iron.
Geez.
Yeah, Becky Malco rips and runs. Malco right side of the floor, high on the right side. Hesitates, now top of Stasiak. Keaton holds, Keaton drives. Keaton goes to the basket, foul on the shot, she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Puckett's going to pick up the foul.
And Morgan Ruff will come in for the first time tonight for Rochester on after the first free throw by Keaton Stasiak. Alexa Garrison will come in as well.
And I think the Lady Zebras are doing a pretty decent job of limiting the Lady Patches' second attempts at the other end of the floor.
Keaton's first one's good. Back into the game is Kristen Cromer. In the game for the first time is Abby Stein for Wabash. Garrison comes in, and Bailey Abbott will sit down. And Morgan will replace Keaton Stasiak if she hits this free throw.
That's going to be big for Garrison at the other end. She's going to have to play bigger than what she is and keep the Lady Patches off
the
board.
Stasiak with one more. Keaton eyes it, flies it. It's good. 12-6. Morgan Ruff comes in. Keaton Stasiak comes out. Rochester now will be Brad in the full court press.
Yep. They've got fresh legs back in the game now with Ruff and Garrison.
Stein gets it into Cromer. Claire Cromer ahead to Stein. Crosses the timeline right. Stein, run stop. Outside to Claire Cromer. Cromer dribbles to the middle of the floor. Switches directions, now runs to the right wing. Now 10 feet away. Leaner on the way for Ruff. It's no good. The rebound to Wabash. Barden kicks it out to Claire Cromer. Wide open three. Left wing is no good off the mark. Rebound fought for. Wabash comes out of there with it. And Malco is going... Nope, they're going to lose it off the hands of Wabash. They're going to say last touch by the Apaches as Malco hits the floor hard. It'll go back to Rochester.
And that's where Abbott was so useful in there for the Lady Zebras. That time, the Lady Apaches had three attempts at that basket.
Yeah. Holland with the top of the key. Fakes, drive, step back, loses the handle. Claire Cromer picks her pocket. Cromer right side of the floor. She'll go in. Right-handed layup. And on the layup, she is fouled by Holland. And that's going to send Claire Cromer to the line to shoot. Two freebies.
Yeah. I think Holland needs to show a little bit of respect for Cromer down here on the other end of the floor. She's not going to get that step-back shot as easily as she has previously this season.
Cromer is almost as automatic as a layup. First free throw is good.
Yeah.
You almost want to just say, take the layup and keep the foul.
And I get the frustration at the other end by Holland committing the foul, you know, not allowing her to get that layup, but... You're not gaining anything sending her to the line.
Claire misses one, but an offensive rebound. The putback is no good, and Holland to the rebound. Barden misses, makes that sign, misses the point-blank jumper. As Holland goes in for the layup, it's off the mark, no good. Rebound to the Wabash Lady Apaches. Ritter gives off to Claire Cromer against Holland, works to the right wing. The down low give and go to Stein. Stein back outside to Claire Cromer for three. Wide open is good again.
Somebody got off of Cromer, lost their assignment.
Wabash cuts the Rochester lead to two. It's 12-10 with under two to play in the first quarter. It's crossover dribble. Down low to Garrison. Layup is no good. Rebound fall four. And Wabash and Claire Cromer comes out of there with it.
That's a good habit back in the game.
Yep, she's coming. Cromer looks at a three. Fakes. Shoots. Nope. Offensive rebound again, and then that pass is knocked away. Stein picks it up. Her putback no good, and now we're going to have an over-the-back foul on Wabash, I believe. Rochester going to get it back as Keaton Stasiak will come back in.
Cromer has nine in this first quarter already for the Lady Apaches. Nine of their ten.
She's got to. I mean, she's averaging 27.
Yeah, and the Lady Zebras hopefully now with Abbott Stasiak back in the game can get back into that rhythm of limiting the Lady Apaches to one and done. They did a good job of that early, but then when Abbott Stasiak took to the bench, the Lady Apaches were getting three and four opportunities to try and get the ball in. They weren't very successful, but they were getting the shot.
90 seconds of play, first quarter. Rochester up 12-10. Holland high on the left side. X to Ruff, middle of the floor. Ruff against Stone. Takes her right, kicks it out to Malco. Quick three, right wing, way off the mark. And the rebound to Puckett. Puckett now to Cromer. Claire Cromer, middle of the floor, gives back to Puckett high on the right side. Puckett drives hard. Her floater on the way is short. Rebound, fought for. Ruff comes out of there with it. Morgan rips and runs. Morgan then has her pocket picked from behind. There should have been a travel there, no call. And now Claire Cromer has it. Middle of the floor for Wabash. Cromer in the middle of the Puckett. Puckett in the paint, travels, going back to Rochester.
And the Lady Zebras have got to take a deep breath and calm down. They've gotten a little rattled here the last couple of possessions.
Mullet comes back into the game, and Barden will sit down. 57.8 to play in the first quarter, Rochester by two.
They've had some good looks and missed them. And they're going to have to take advantage of those good opportunities when they get them.
And good looks mean inside 5 feet.
Inside three.
Holland, top to Stasiak with 45. Keaton drives it right. Cut off by the defense. Outside to Malco with 42. Becky in the paint. At the free throw line, now outside to Ruff with 38. Morgan, one dribble, high on the right side to Holland with 36. Now to Malco, holds with 33. Becky works to the right wing, just got away with the carry with 28 seconds. Now Ruff has it. Ruff around the defense, out to Holland with 25. X dribbled to her right with 22. Now Malco holds a 20. She drives in the paint, kicks it outside to Ruff with 18. Morgan Ruff drives it down low, kicks it out to Holland with 14. Now quickly to Malco with 13. Malco pulls it out to the center circle with 10. Now with 9. Now with 8. With 7. With 6. Malco drives it right with 5. Malco drives, going to be fouled with 3.1, and she hits the floor hard. I believe Mullet's going to pick up the foul.
Or is it going to be Cromer?
Oh,
baby. Cromer picks up her second foul here in the first quarter. Claire.
3.1 seconds to play in the first quarter. Claire Cromer's just picked up foul number 2. Rochester looking for the final shot of the quarter. Holland looks to get it in. Over the top of the defense to Malco. Malco, shot at the buzzer on the way. No good. After one, Rochester leads 12-10. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Rochester starts the second quarter of the basketball. Holland on the baseline. Now back to Malco, high on the left side. Malco in the paint. Jump pass down low to Abbott. Outside to Holland. Three, left wing is no good. Off the mark. Ruff with the rebound. Her putback no good. Stacey with the rebound. The putback is good. Rochester up 14-10.
And that's what the Lady Zebras need, is multiple shots at the basket when they have the opportunity and make it.
Claire Cromer high on the right side. To the middle of the floor to Stone. Quickly left side to Kristen Cromer inside the three-point line. Passes tip. Stone has it for Wabash. Back to Kristen Cromer. Kristen Cromer gives to Claire Cromer. Outside the three-point line. Left wing. Top to Stone. Stone fakes the three. Outside to Mullet. Pass tip around. Abbott steals it. Rochester has it. Holland runs to the left. Rochester up by 4. Holland, three. Left wing. Nope. Rebound fault 4, and Wabash comes out of there, and Holland just picked up foul number 2. Frustration foul. Allie Larkin will come into the game.
And now the Rochester Lady Zebras are going to be working with foul trouble on Holland, which could be a problem.
Holland has 2. Claire Cromer for Wabash has 2.
And Coach Stone saying, well, you know what? Claire's just going to have to prove her ability to play with 2 fouls.
Yep,
he can't
right.
afford to take her out.
Stone and Rochester in a box and 1. The chaser is Morgan Ruff on Claire Cromer. Claire outside left. Leaner on the way from 15 feet is no good. And Larkin rips the board.
And you know what? Even if you don't stop her, you have to make her work hard for the basket.
Right. Malco to Stasiak, left side. Drives it right. Bounce pass to Malco. Fakes a 3. Drives in the paint. Leaner off the glass. No good. Rebound fall 4. Malco comes out of there with it. Bounce pass to Larkin. Larkin, top to Stasiak, left side to Ruff. She'll fire a 3 from the left wing. Way off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Claire Cromer. Claire Cromer runs for Wabash. 14-10, Lady Zebras with 6:15 to play in the first half.
Cromer. Freshman Ruff, the guarding duties on Cromer.
Box to 1 right now for the Rochester defense. Stone, high on the right side. Dribbles to the middle of the floor. Bounce pass in the lane to Kristen Cromer. Kristen Cromer, leaner over Bailey Abbott, no good. Rebound fault 4, and Ruff comes out of there with it. Gives to Stasiak. Keaton runs middle of the floor for Rochester, up by 4. Stasiak outside left to Malco. Becky in the paint to Morgan Ruff. Another 3 on the way, no good. And the long rebound. Wabash grabs it, and Stasiak knocks Kristen Cromer to the floor hard and is going to pick up a foul.
The Lady Zebras, I think, are getting comfortable just sitting back on that three-point shot. Unfortunately, they're not shooting a very high percentage.
Yeah.
They started out the game really, really hot, and now they've gone cold, and Cromer's going to come out of the game for the Lady Apaches. And
now the defense has changed.
Yeah. well, she's got all but 1 point for the Lady Apaches. So now you're going to be looking to see who scores. Who's going to be the scorer?
Kristen.
Yeah, you got to look at Puckett.
Puckett in the lane. Down, down, up, pass. Loses the handle. Stasiak picks it up. Gives to Larkin. Rochester runs up by four. 5.5 to play in the first half.
We got to take advantage.
Larkin to Malco. Left side to Ruff. Ruff in the wing. Inside the three-point line. Out to Larkin. Her pass is tipped away. And it's going to go out of bounds. Last touch by Wabash. It'll stay with Rochester on the far side. And the Apaches will make a substitution as Claire Kramer will come back into the game. Varden and also Ritter will come back in as well. So Kramer didn't get much of a blow, but she's back in.
I think it was just a matter of get a drink of water and let the coach pep her up a little bit, give her some advice, and back in she comes.
Malco, leaner, is partially blocked. Rebound fall for her. It's going to go out of bounds. Last touch by Wabash. It'll stay baseline right with 5:10 to play in the first half with Rochester up by four. Hannah Odell will come in the game for the first time for Rochester. Odell will replace Morgan Ruff.
Well, the first half we played Rochester's game. The second half we're playing Wabash's game.
Yeah, yeah.
So the lower score this turns out to be, I think, the more plays in the Wabash's favor.
Malco over the defense. Larkin has it. Now knocked in the backcourt. Stasiak picks it up to Allie Larkin. Larkin high on the right side for Rochester. Back to Stasiak, left wing in the corner to Malco. Malco loses the handle. And we're going to have a foul on Becky Malco for on the reach-in.
Yep. Well, that's about the third Lady Zebra foul tonight that we've seen where somebody's made a mistake or a bad play and then turn around and get the foul trying to correct it.
Yeah. Under five to play in the first half. Rochester up 14-10. Wabash basketball going to our right. Oh, boy. They missed back door to Ritter right there, didn't they? Claire Kramer works to the right side against Odell. Three on the way, right baseline. Good. Make that a two. And it's 14-10. Kramer has 11 of the 12.
Yes.
Malco drives it left. Crossover dribble. Loses the handle. Picks it up on the volleyball line. Now we'll start over. Wabash in a 2-3 zone. Tries to split the double team. Works it right side. Share pocket pick. Picked up by Wabash. Coast to coast. A shot good and a foul as J.C. Parrott is fouled a shot to get to the go. Keaton Stasiak picks up the foul. And the junior will make that the sophomore will go to the line to shoot one.
Now Stasiak's got two.
Back into the game for Wabash is Dine. And coming out is Puckett. 4:22 to play in the first half. Wabash looking for their first lead of the night. Parrott has one, looking to complete the three-point play. It's on the way. It is in and out and no good. But the offensive rebound to Stein. Stein outside to Claire Kramer. We're tied at 14 with 4:15 to play in the first half. Right side to Parrott. Parrott over the top of the defense to Kramer. Kramer gets a pick, drives it left. Down low to Braden. Outside to Parrott. Jumper no good. Stasiak with the rebound to the rim. And she is fouled on the way up the court. And it'll be out of bounds to Rochester on the far side as Morgan Ruff will come back into the game for Rochester. With 4:02 to play in the first half, we're tied at 14.
A foul on Barton, her first.
You got to wonder how much gas in the tank Ruff got left because she's been sick a lot this week.
You're right.
Now Stasiak comes out, so both Stasiak and Holland on the bench with two fouls. It'll be Rochester basketball, and I think Coach Stasiak will look to run some clock here. Under four to play in the first half, we're tied at 14. Malco to Ruff. Ruff holds him on the top of the key. Now to Larkin, back to Ruff, right side. Morgan, back to Larkin between the rings. Sends left wing to Malco. Malco with the elbow extended left. To Larkin, back to Malco, left wing. Malco in the paint. Rises up, shot on the way, is short. And the rebound to Wabash. And Stein gives to Kramer. Claire Kramer works left hard. He's outside to Parrott. Parrott jumper is on the way, no good. Another offensive rebound for Wabash. Outside to Kramer, three right wing, in and out, no good. And Malco with the board. Malco rips and runs for Rochester. We're tied at 14, 3:15 to play in the first half. Malco loses the handle, picked up by Kramer. Claire Kramer, right side of the floor against Ruff, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, it's good. 16-14, Wabash's first lead of the half comes at 3:07 to play in the first half.
Kramer now with 15.
Malco drives it left, kicks it out to Ruff. Morgan, top of the key to Larkin. Right side to Odell. Back to Larkin. Man-to-man defense. Larkin drives. kicks it out to Malco. Three, left wing, in and out, and back in.
Wow, they needed that one.
Rochester back up 17-16.
You know, the thing about the Lady Apaches, they may only have one score, but they've got five people that are pretty good at defense.
Yeah. Down low to a wide open Parrott. Her 10-footer is good. We're just standing around. It's like we're gassed right now.
Yeah.
I don't get it. Just standing around watching. 2:20 to play, first half. 18-17 Wabash. Malco in the paint. And she's going to be fouled. And it's going to be the 16th foul for Wabash. So both teams will be shooting free throws from here on out.
So Parrott picks up the foul.
So Kristen Cromer, Stone, and Puckett back into the game for Wabash. Malco will look to trigger in, baseline left. Becky studies, looks over the top of the defense to Abbott, who's back in the game. Bailey, bounce pass to Larkin. Now to Malco. Malco on the wing behind the arc. The rough between the circles to Malco for three, short. Offensive rebound to Bailey Abbott, who loses the handle to Stone. Now to Claire Cromer. Wabash runs up by one. Cromer then will pick her way through the defense and top to Stone. Stone back to Cromer. 5 feet behind the arc, right wing. Ivoyale has that shot. To Kristen Cromer, to Stone. She'll fire a three, left wing. No good. And Morgan Ruff knocks the basketball out of bounds. It'll stay with Wabash. Yep. As Alexa Garrison will come back into the game with a minute 44 to play in the first half. Yep. Rochester down by one.
The freshman Ruff has got to get that rebound. She had the block out. She had the position. The ball hits her in the hands. Goes out of bounds. She's got to get that effort.
Stone gets into Claire Cromer against Garrison. Back to Stone. She drives. Cut off by the defense. A pair to the right elbow. Gives to Claire Cromer. Over the top. Pass to Parrott. Parrott down low to Puckett. Her jumper's good. Sarah Puckett, I believe, has her first two of the game. The Wabash by three. The minute 25 to play in the first half.
One of the things the Lady Zebras are doing is as soon as the one defender gets picked off on Cromer, the other four are trying to pick up the loose, you know, the defense. And it's leaving the other three players for Wabash wide open.
Morgan Ruff is hit hard, no call. Puckett for three, right corner is no good. Weak side rebound to Larkin. Larkin picks up the dribble. We're going to have a 30-second Rochester timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. A minute 7 to play in the first half. Rochester trails the Wabash Lady Apaches 20-17. And Keaton Stasiak back into the game, and Morgan Ruff is out. Now all five of the original starters back in for Rochester. It's been a while since we've seen that.
Yep, we have. And you gotta wonder how cold Holland is. She's usually the hot hand that gets everything rolling for the Lady Zebras.
Coach Stasiak will look for the final shot of the period. We're down to 60 seconds left in the first half. Rochester down by three. Their biggest lead has been six. Six in this half. Malco to Holland. High on the left side to Larkin. Back to Holland between the rings of Stasiak. To Holland, middle of the floor. Left side to Larkin. Now to Stasiak with 42. Back to Larkin. Holds with 40. To Stasiak. Drives it right out to Stasiak. Now to Larkin with 35. Hallie holds with 33. Wabash allowing her to hold with 32. Larkin holds with 29. Now to Stasiak near the timeline with 25. Keaton holds with 24. Bounce pass to Larkin with 22. Larkin drives it right with 19. Now to Holland, back to Larkin in the center circle with 17. Larkin, one dribble going to the right with Holland with 13.
The last thing you want to happen is for Holland to pick up another foul.
Exactly.
Making a drive.
Or Stasiak.
Yeah, or Stasiak.
Malco with six. Gives to Bailey Abbott. Bounce pass to Holland with three. The shot at the buzzer is no good. At halftime, Wabash leads 20-17. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball on 82.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account, learn more about our online banking options, or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save.
And Cromer, Claire Cromer for the Lady Apaches with two.
Rochester set to both girls with two for a while. Claire Cromer set for what, 30 seconds?
Maybe not even that. Thing is now with Rochester trailing, Wabash is going to start playing their game, which is slow and methodical, and Cromer is going to look for openings for herself or her teammates.
Claire Cromer against the double team over the defensive bucket. Bucket high on the left side over top of Claire Cromer between the rings.
Yep, Lady Zebras are going to have to try and force the issue. They're going to have to force a shot, and they do.
Stone jumper goes from 15 feet, and Wabash up by five at 22-17. Man-to-man defense by Wabash.
They've got to do a much better job attacking the Lady Apaches on this side of the floor.
2-3 zone, I beg your pardon. Malco almost has the ball stolen between the defense. Stasiak kicks it out to Larkin, drives the baseline. Outside to Stasiak, right side, top of the key to Malco. Malco in the paint. Dump pass down low to Bailey. Abbott layup is short, and then the ball is knocked out of bounds by Wabash.
Those are the opportunities you've got to have. There's just no excuse for it. You've got to make them.
Rochester will keep possession, baseline right. Holland looks to get it in. Bounce pass in the corner to Larkin. Alley to Malco. Back to Alley to Malco. Left side, Holland. X looks to the three, to Becky, top of the key. Drives it left, kicks it out to Holland. Three on the way, left side, good!
Holland from about two steps behind the arc, drains that three.
22-20, Wabash. Stone, across the timeline, high on the right side, around the defense in the corner to Kristen Cromer. She drives the baseline, throws up a shot, no good. Ball knocked out of bounds by Abbott. It'll stay with Wabash, baseline left. So Coach Stasiak didn't like the no call. Coach Stone didn't like the no call.
Right.
And the official standing between them is getting it for both ears.
One won the charge, the other one wanted the block.
Puckett
called it out of bounds.
Looks down low, spins left side to Mullet, to Stone, to Puckett. Puckett drives a couple of times, spinner on the way. Blocks the shot, Stasiak with the rebound. Keaton gives to Holland. Rochester down by two, 6.5 to play in the third. Malco drives the baseline, pull-up jumper over Puckett is no good, but a foul coming on Puckett, that's going to send Malco to the line to shoot two. 6:27 to play in the third quarter. Wabash leading 22-20, and Malco at the line to shoot two, and looking to tie this one up.
Yeah, Puckett's going to pick up first, second.
Good. Malco hides the first one, lets it fly, it's no good. One more coming for the junior. I'm sure you heard that. That's Coach Stone.
Yeah.
He's loud. One more coming for Malco. Now looking to cut the Wabash lead to one. Becky's second on the way. Good this time.
Well, I'll tell you what, there's an awful lot on the line for both of these teams when it comes to the conference.
And yes, I would agree with that. Maybe more on the line at this point for Wabash than Rochester.
Yeah.
Claire Cromer around the defense.
And when you're on the road, you got to keep your girls excited.
Oh, my good Lord. Claire Cromer's, I don't know, 35'3" is no good. Rebound to Stasiak. She rips and runs. Keaton hesitates. Kicks it outside to Larkin. Now top to Malco. Malco in the paint. Loses the handle. Claire Cromer with the rebound. The pick.
Cromer probably could have picked up her third on that one.
And then she has her pocket picked by Holland. And then Holland is going to be fouled by Mullet. With under six to play in the third quarter, Rochester down by one.
Mullet picks up her first, team second.
Rochester will inbound right in front of the Wabash bench going to our right. 5:58 to play in the third. Wabash leading 22-21. And Becky Malco through the center circle. Fakes it right. Goes left to Holland. Back to Malco to Larkin. Becky to Malco. Back to Larkin. Larkin
Stasiak encouraging his girls to take it at him.
Download it. Abbott. Abbott kicks it out to Malco. Three in the lead. Right side is short. No good. And the rebound, fall four, and we're going to have a tie-up, and Rochester going to get possession. Rochester, Keaton Stasiak working hard down low against Kristen Cromer.
And that's what they need. They need to try and create opportunities for themselves and then take advantage of it when they get them. And they've got to limit the Lady Apache's opportunities at the other end.
Right. Gets it into Malco, crosses the timeline, middle of the floor, left side of Holland. X around the defense. Becky now right side to Larkin. Feeds down low to Stasiak. Keaton forces the pass. Rochester turns it over. Claire Cromer now runs for Wabash.
That equals the amount of turnovers they had against the whole game against Southwood.
Ball at the Cromer. In the lane to Kristen Cromer. Jumper over Stasiak and off the mark, no good. Keaton rips and now off to Holland. Quickly to Larkin. Allie slows up, middle of the floor, outside to Malco. She dumps down low to Abbott. Her jumper in the lane is good, and we're up 23-22. We're under five to play in the third.
Great job by Abbott to seal off her defender and create a passing lane for Malco to pass it.
Cromer in the corner to Kristen Cromer. She goes to the basket, fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Is that Larkin or Stasiak?
I think Larkin's going to. Malarkin may pick that one up.
Number 30, Allie. That'll be three on Larkin.
Second.
No, two, okay. And that's going to send Kristen Cromer to the line to shoot two for Wabash. The Lady Zebras up 23-22.
One of four from the line is Kristen Cromer.
Cromer's first one too hard. And Morgan Ruff coming back in. Larkin to sit down. Congratulations to the Rochester Wrestlers. Went 5-0 today at the Logan Sport Tournament. They beat Benton Central 45-23, defeated Logan 46-19, defeated CMA 52-24, defeated Delphi 49-23. Kristen Cromer hits one of two. We're tied at 23. Back into the game for Wabash is Barton. So we're tied at 23, 4:48 to play in the third quarter. Rochester basketball going to our right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman at Rochester High School. Malco runs a point through the center circle against the 2-3 zone of the Wabash Lady Apaches. The rough high on the right side to Malco, swings in the middle of the floor, outside to Holland for three, left wing, good!
Holland with her second three this quarter, keeping the Lady Zebras alive.
4.5 to play in the third, Rochester by three. Claire Cromer directs traffic top of the key, works right side against Malco. Gets the pick, works behind the pick, outside to Stone, quickly to Puckett in the paint. Puckett outside to Stone, left side to Cromer. Three in the way, we're going to have a legal screen coming against the Mullet, and that's going to go back to Rochester.
Mullet will pick up her second, team third.
I didn't see it. Did that ball go in?
I didn't see it either. I don't know.
Turnover Wabash.
I was looking at Coach Stasiak jumping up and down, applauding the call. He's been asking for that since the first quarter.
4:15 to play in the third. Rochester up 26-23. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our right. Malco through the center circle, right side to Ruff. Ruff back to Malco. Drives it, kicks it out to Holland, high on the left side. X with two big threes in this corner to Malco. Pull up 15-foot on the baseline, rattles in.
Malco gets her ninth point of the game.
Rochester back by five at 28-23. Dump down low to Puckett. Puck on the block against the double team to a wide open Parrott. Her layup is no good. Abbott with the rebound. Actually, that was Ritter, wasn't it?
Yeah.
To Holland. Rochester by five and runs. In the baseline to Malco. Malco, cross court to Stasiak. Keaton, 18-footer, right side off the mark, no good. Bailey Abbott with the rebound. Kicks it out to Malco, 18-footer, isn't it out, no good. Bailey's rabbit put back is good and a foul.
Great job, great effort by Bailey Abbott, the senior for the Lady Zebras. Two big rebounds, and the second one creates an opportunity for herself to get to the free throw line for the and one, and Sarah Puckett picks up her third for the Lady Apaches.
Coach Stone just lost his tie. 30-23 Rochester, biggest lead of the night. Bailey Abbott with one free throw. Senior's shot on the way is good. No rotation, but nothing but the bottom of the net.
And that's the 10th point for the senior Bailey Abbott, the first one in double for the Lady Zebras.
31-23. Cromer high on the right side for Wabash. Gives outside to Parrott, who's back in the game. And now we're going to have a legal screen again as Becky Malco hits the floor hard. And I believe Ritter's going to pick up another legal screen.
Ritter picks up her first.
3:15 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up by eight, 31-23. And Coach Stasiak's going to look to take the air out of the ball here. Malco runs right side, and she is fouled on the way to the basket. Is that going to be on Parrott? Well, I think he's going to take the air out of it. Maybe that's a decoy to say go to the basket.
Yeah, well, you know, that is Parrott's second foul, team six. And with the next one, the Lady Zebras will shoot free throws from here on out. And the thing is, that's what Malco does. That's her, you know, first attack on the ball. Is just put it into the paint and see what she can create.
3 minutes to play in the third. Rochester up 31-23. Malco on the right wing. Takes it right. Loses the basketball. Last touch by Malco. We'll go back to Wabash. Boy, Cromer, Claire Cromer has such quick hands.
Yeah, she does. She does a lot of things well.
2:50 to play in the third. Parrott high on the right side. Over the top of the defense. Almost stolen. Down low to Ritter. She travels.
That's only the eighth turnover by the Lady Apaches.
Well, they've had three in this quarter. Allie Larkin will come back into the game, and I believe Morgan Ruff will come out.
Oh, the Lady Apaches coach has got a warning.
Stone just got warned. 2:43 to play in the third. Rochester up by eight at 31-23. Malco, man-to-man defense. Works it right in the paint. Outside to Holland. Three left wing. And no good. And the rebound to Wabash. Boy, that looked good, didn't it?
Yeah, it looked good all the way. Again, so it hit the iron.
Parrott drives it right against Holland. Picks up the dribble. Outside to Barton. Barton over the top of the defense. To Puckett. Puckett loses the handle. Picked up by Malco. Malco will go in for the right-handed layup. It's off the window and good. Rochester by 10. Timeout Wabash. It's a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball. 92.1 WROI. In the third quarter, Rochester up 33-23. Claire Cromer works against Becky Malco,
who's had a fabulous third quarter, especially defensively against the Lady Wabash Apaches.
Puckett to Claire Cromer. Rochester, are they in a triangle in two? Cromer
yeah.
Picks her way through the defense, throws up an errant shot. She was out of control, and she's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the lane to shoot two.
So that foul's against Abbott. That'll be her second, team second. Cromer going to the line looking for her first points in this third quarter. She had 13 at halftime.
So Cromer at the line for two. First one on the way is good. Back into the game is Kristen Cromer and also Stein.
The Lady Zebras have outscored the Lady Apaches 16-4 in this quarter.
Yeah, they needed it.
Yeah,
third quarter. Boy, that's notorious this year. Third quarter has been really good for Rochester.
With the exception of a couple of games, Culver and LaBelle.
Second for Claire Cromer is no good. And the rebound is Stasiak.
Rare.
Yeah, exactly. Holland runs right hard. Holland through the defense. Pull up jumper over the defense. Good! The foul!
Holland with the three-pointer the old-fashioned way.
Holland from about 10 feet away was fouled on the shot. She got it to go, and she'll go to the line to shoot one.
And a foul on Stein, her first. That puts the Lady Zebras in the one and the bonus.
Holland at the line to shoot one, looking to push this lead to 12. 35-24 Rochester. X has one freebie. Holland eyes it, flies it. Nope. Rebound to Stasiak. Has knocked out of bounds by Wabash. It'll stay with the Lady Zebras.
Holland picked up her 10th point with that bucket. Eight of them in this quarter.
Holland looks to trigger it in. Baseline right. X studies. Bounce pass into Larkin right in front of Coach Stasiak. She pulls up from 10 feet short. And the rebound to Stein, who gives up to Claire Cromer. She carries the basketball. A minute 37 to play in the third. Rochester by 11. It'll be Rochester basketball right in front of their bench. Larkin to look to get it in. Allie looks. Bounce pass in the corner to Malco. Back to Larkin high on the right side. She drives in the paint. Stops outside to Bailey Abbott. 10-footer off the window is good. Bailey Abbott a monster night.
Yep, she's got her seventh point in this quarter. 12 for the ball game.
37-24. Claire Cromer. Works high on the right side, crossover dribble in the paint. Her leaner on the way off the glass is good. Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's roll. A minute 10 to play. Now he says, let's spread it out and take some air out of it. Malco, High left side to Holland. Back to Malco with a minute five. Malco around the defense at the free throw line. Cut off by the defense. Bounce pass to Holland between the rings in the minute. Larkin now has it between the circles of the volleyball line. Works right side at the elbow. Cut off by the defense to Malco in the corner. To Stasiak to Holland with 50.
They got to take care of the ball. Make good passes. A couple of those were pretty scary.
Malco in the right corner with 45. Now top of the key to Malco, or with Holland with 42. X drives now to Malco with 40. Malco in the lane. Kicks it back outside to Larkin. She has her pocket pick. Now we're going to have a foul at Allie Larkin.
Yeah, Larkin with the tackle. That's going to be her third. And that's not a good thing for the Lady Zebras.
35.5 to play in the third. Rochester up by 11 at 37-26. Morgan Ruff will come back in the game for Rochester, and Allie Larkin with three fouls will come out.
Larkin hasn't scored tonight, but she's been in double digits for the last four games the Lady Zebras have played.
Parrott around the defense. Cut off by the double team. Parrott looking for Kristen Cromer. Gives to Claire Cromer with 25. Through the defense. Split the defense. Down low to Barton. Her jumper is good for the baseline. Rochester's lead cut to 9 with 19. X then slows up with 17. Crosses the timeline. Oh, got away with a tough pass to Malco with 13. Malco holds with 12. Dribbles, pulls it out with 9. Middle floor with 7. Now high on the right side with 6. Bounce pass to Matt Holland with 3. X loses the basketball. X will have to shoot from the volleyball line with 1. After 3, Rochester leading 37-28. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time home buyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender.
4th and final quarter here at Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras leading by 9 at 37-28. Wabash starts the 4th and final period of the basketball going to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Lady Zebras got to bring the same energy to this quarter they had in the third.
Puckett against the double team, and she is fouled by Ruff.
Ruff picks up her first, team fourth.
Out of bounds, baseline left. It's Kristen Cromer. She'll look to trigger it in. Rochester up by 9. Gives to
Claire
Cromer on the wing. To Stone. To Mullet. Mullet, one dribble. Gives to wide open Kristen Cromer, and she puts it in for 2. Wide open. 37-30.
Defensively, they just lost track of who they had.
Malco gives to Holland. Holland catches the ball right out of her face. Yorks against Claire Cromer. Outside to Ruff. Ruff a couple of dribbles. X in the corner. Holland back to Ruff, high on the right side. Dribbles a couple of times to her left. She works against Claire Cromer. Now around the defense. Outside to Holland. 3 right side. Good!
Holland with her third three-pointer.
40-30. Rochester by 10. 7 minutes to play in the game. Stone in the corner to Mullet. Mullet doesn't even look to score. To Puckett. Puckett outside to Stone. 10-footer right side. It's good. And not a very pretty shot, but she gets it to go. 40-32. Rochester by 8 with 6:40 to play in the game. Malco works high on the right side. Crossover dribble in the paint. Kicks it out to Ruff. Ruff holds. Now to Stasiak. Back to Ruff. Middle of the floor. Left side to Malco. Becky. Couple of dribbles. Dribbles right. Now picks up the dribble. Out to Ruff between the circles of the volleyball line. Morgan against Stone. Backs it out to the timeline. Ruff. Right to the hands of Holland.
Too hard, too close a pass. She threw it too hard.
And now it's Claire Cromer. Cromer, top of the key, works high on the right side. Picks up a dribble to Stone. Left side to Kristen Cromer. Outside to Claire Cromer. Three left wing for Wabash. Is off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Holland. Rochester leads by eight, under six to play in the game.
Great job. They need to limit those attempts.
Holland goes to the basket hard, foul on the shot. She'll go to the lane to shoot two.
Kristen Cromer going to pick up her first, team eight.
5:54 to play in the game. Rochester by eight. Edges the line to shoot two, looking to push this lead back to 10. Their biggest has been 11.
I believe you're right, yes.
Holland's first one on the way. Good. One more coming for the junior. Looking to push this lead back to 10 for Rochester. Allie Larkin will come back into the game. The second one good again by X. Larkin in. Beck comes out. She must be winded. I think she was asked to come out.
I think so. I hate to see that. Hopefully she'll get back in here.
Yeah, I agree.
In less than a minute.
So X now has Cromer. Claire, that is. Works high to the right side. Loft over the pass. Down low to Kristen Cromer. Her shot's blocked by Morgan Ruff, but a foul coming on the body. That's going to send Kristen Cromer to the line to shoot two.
I don't mind that at all. I'd rather see the foul than the easy layup. Kristen Cromer has been horrible from the free throw line.
42-32, Rochester by 10 with 5:40 to play in the game. Kristen Cromer at the line to shoot two for the Lady Apache.
She's 2 of 6 from the line.
First one for the junior. Nope. She'll have one more. Now she's 2 of 7.
Yeah. And you know that the freshman Ruff is not going to be in the game till the end.
Yeah.
So if she picks up 3-4 fouls out here, who cares?
Yep. They're fouling her.
Yeah.
Second one by Cromer is good this time. 42-33. One thing Wabash has not done, I don't believe, is they haven't pressed at all tonight, have they?
No. I don't think they can afford to.
I think you're right. Holland against Cromer. Outside to Ruff. Ruff in the paint. Dumps down low to Abbott. Abbott back to Ruff and travels.
You know, the Lady Apaches do such a great job in that 2-3 zone of attacking the ball handler and taking away the passing lanes. I don't think they can keep up with a team like us, especially in a full court game.
Yeah. Rochester by 9, 5:25 to play in the game. Cromer gives to Kristen Cromer on the left wing. She drives it, pull up from 10 foot off the glass is good. I'd rather see somebody foul her than leave her that wide open.
Yeah, you're right. She's got 5 in this quarter, 7 for the game.
Abbott out to Holland, fakes a 3, drives it. Now to Malker. She fakes a 3 and she travels.
Wow. Well, that's the third straight turnover for the Lady Zebras.
42-35 Rochester, 5:07 to play in the game. Rochester's biggest lead has been 11. That came in the second quarter.
Third quarter, that's right.
Becky Malko works against Claire Cromer. Cromer through the center circle for Wabash.
Now I kind of get the feeling they're just playing for the clock to run, you know, playing not to lose.
Yeah, that's right. Down low to Puckett. Puckett turnaround jumper over Bailey. Abbott is good. And now the lead is down to 5.
And the 4:40 to play. Are getting offense from their subordinates, I guess you would say. Cromer has not scored in this quarter. He's only got 3 in this half.
Claire Cromer now to Malko. Malko drives. Dump down low to Bailey Abbott. Loses the handle. Ball loose. It's going to be picked up by Puckett in the corner. Puckett over the top of the defense. Now to Stone. Stone quickly up the floor to Kristen Cromer. Kristen Cromer on the baseline. Jumper over Abbott is partially blocked. Ball backed out of bounds. It's going to go to... I know Stasiak and Stone is fighting for it. Who's it going to go to?
I think it's going to need to go back to the Lady Zebras.
It's going to be a jump ball here.
They're going to throw it up in the circle. No, they're going to get
it. Stasiak touched it last.
Wow.
Stasiak touched it last. Rochester will keep it out of bounds. 4:18 to play in the game. Rochester by 5. Stone baseline left. Looks to trigger it in. Stone bounce past the Puckett. Puckett to the baseline. Drives in the paint. Little baby hook shot on the way is no good. And the rebound knocked out of bounds by Stasiak again. It will stay with Wabash. And back into the game is Ritter. And coming out is Kristen Cromer.
Well, as Sarah Puckett for the Lady Apaches has decided to show up in this quarter, Bailey Abbott's had her hands full, doing a pretty good job for the most part. But what that does is it takes away the rebounding. The Lady Zebras need to find somebody to get a rebound and stop the possession by the Lady Apaches.
Claire Cromer to Puckett. Puckett then is fouled, going to the basket by Holland. It'll be out of bounds to Wabash. 4:06 to play in the game. Rochester by 5.
Holland will pick up her third. And I think at this point, you just have to leave them in.
I agree.
Four minutes to go in a close ball game.
You got Barrett back into the game, and Stone comes out. 4:06 to play in the game. Rochester by five. Injury pass comes in to Puckett. Puckett, three in the right wing. Good as it rattles in. Rochester's lead down to two. It's an 8-0 run for Wabash. Holland, top of the key against Cromer. Holland backs it out. Sends right side to Malco. Malco around the pick. In the paint. Outside to Holland. Heck. Looks at a three. Gives him the corner to Malco. Three on the baseline is no good. Rolls nothing but air. And the rebound to Wabash. Wabash, an opportunity to tie or take the lead with this possession. Claire Cromer behind the arc left wing. Her pass is deflected and taken by Larkin. Now ahead to Malco. Malco will go to the basket. Her right hand layup is good.
Great job by Larkin to get the steal and Malco the layup.
44-40. Rochester up with 3:20 to play in the game. And now Wabash loses it out of bounds. You're going to see last touch by Holland. Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. Rochester leading 44-40. Been back and forth about the entire game. Rochester had a 10-point lead in this quarter, had an 11-point lead in the third quarter. Saw both of them evaporate down to basically nothing.
Yeah, the Lady Apaches had not scored more than 10 points in a quarter, and they're at 10 points here in the fourth with a little over three minutes to go.
Wabash tries an entry pass, deflects it right to the hands of Barton. Her jumper no good. Larkin to the rebound. Larkin gives to Holland. 3:10 to play in the game. 44-40, Rochester leads. Malco down low to Abbott. Back to Malco high on the left side.
Coach Stasiak wants to pull it out and run the clock.
Malco works left side. Gives out to Abbott. Bounce pass top the key to Larkin. Under three to play in the game. Rochester by four. Gives to Holland on the right side of the volleyball line. Now to Becky Malco in the middle of the floor. Malco virtually in the center circle. Drives it right. Oh, boy. Bailey Abbott just got away from the legal screen.
Yeah. And the Lady Apache crowd letting the referees know it. Thing is, Lady Zebras will shoot free throws if there's a foul against them.
Stasiak dribbles, top of the key. Now to Malco with a minute. Makes that 2:30, and she has her pocket picked by Cromer. Claire Cromer goes to the basket, throws up a shot, no good, but Becky Malco picks up a foul. Cromer going to go to the line to shoot two with 2:26 to play in the game.
Malco with her second, and that puts the Lady Apaches at 16 fouls, so they'll be in the one in the bonus shortly. Cromer with 16 points in the ball game, looking to add to her totals.
Cromer has two. First on the way for the junior, for the senior is good.
It's always a risk when you decide to pull the air out of the ball.
Yeah, especially with
a small lead. And yeah, you're right. With as quick as the Lady Apaches are and as quick as they are defensively, yeah.
Cromer with one more, looking to get the Rochester lead to two. Claire, second one on the way. Good again. 44-42. Rochester on top with 2:26 to play in the game.
Can you switch back into attack mode?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Wabash has four timeouts, Rochester three. Malco against Stone in man-to-man defense. Outside to Larkin. Larkin against Kristen. Cromer works high on the right side, pulls it out the volleyball line. Now works left side, bounce pass to Malco. Malco holds in the center circle against Stone. 2 minutes to play in the game. Malco works left side in the paint. Loses the handle. Now we're going to have a foul on Kristen Cromer. That's going to send Malco to the line for one and the bonus.
You know, I'd almost like to see Malco pull up with that shot when she gets, you know, 3 feet deep below the free throw line.
2 minutes to play in the game. Rochester by two. Becky Malco at the line for one and the bonus for the Lady Zebras. Becky eyes it. Slice, oh boy,
and
short.
And that's Puckett. What happens when you take the air out of the ball.
Yeah.
Everybody gets tight. You have a tendency to have that happen.
Cromer drives into the baseline, cut off by the defense. Down low to Stone. Her layup on the way is short. Rebound, knocked out of bounds by Holland. It's going to stay with Wabash. A minute 48 to play in the game. Rochester up by two.
They're going to have to get a block out on the miss and get their hands on a rebound.
Puck in at the left elbow, a minute 45 to play. DeClaire Cromer, three for the lead. No good. Holland with the rebound. Het dribbles up the floor. Rochester the numbers. Holland M pulls it out with a minute 35 to play. Holland then to Malka, or makes it to Larkin, and Holland fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, is that going to be Claire's third? It is. Claire Cromer picks up her third, which isn't that big a deal because there's no way she's coming out of the ballgame.
93 seconds of play in the basketball game. Rochester up by two. Holland at the line for two. X first one. Good. One more coming for the junior, looking to push this to four.
Which is big.
Oh, boy.
With the three-point shooters that Wabash has.
Second one for X. Good again. And now Wabash will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Seconds to play in regulation. Rochester up 46-42. It'll be Wabash basketball out of bounds underneath the Rochester basket going to our left, Brad.
Lady Zebras looking to get a monkey off their back. They haven't beat the Lady Apaches in 8 years, and this would be the biggest win of the start of this season for them.
How many turnovers do we have?
I have us for 16 turnovers. Lady Apaches, 11. Holland with 17 in the basketball game now. She's a perfect 4-for-4 from the free throw line here in the fourth quarter.
Rochester in a full court press. Kristen Cromer will look to get it in underneath the Rochester basket. Kristen Cromer gets it into Stone. Stone pushes, crosses the timeline left. Rochester by four, picks up the dribble, gets the puck in the corner.
Malco shadowing Claire Cromer.
Cromer has it now, crossover dribble, picks it out to Puckett. Puckett inside the three-point line, in the paint, hands off to Barden. Barden out to Puckett with a minute 15 to play. Rochester by four. Puckett loses it. Holland has it. Holland right side of the floor. Pulls it outside and will run some clock. A minute five to play. Rochester by four. Larkin against Kristen Cromer. Back to Holland. Middle of the floor. Heck holds with a minute. Drives it right. Kicks it out to Malco near the scorer's table with 56. Left side around the defense. Travels. Claire Cromer should have picked up a foul. Oh, they're going to have a foul calling for
this. They're going to call the travel and the turnover on Malco after she and Claire Cromer got their feet tangled up.
52.9 to play in the game. Rochester by four. Claire Cromer with the basketball. Just don't foul on a three-point shot.
You're right.
Dribbles left side. Works against Malco. Out to Stone. Stone drives it to the elbow. Cut off of the defense. And then the ball is tipped off of the shoulder of Malco. Picked up by Cromer. Cromer has the basketball. Picked away from the defense. Throws up a shot. No good. Offensive rebound. Put back. No good. Abbott with the rebound. Abbott is fouled on the rebound. Sugar to the line to shoot two.
Great job by Abbott keeping that ball alive and getting her a rebound inside and picking up the foul.
Bradley, Becky Malco is gassed.
Yeah, she is. I saw that at the timeout. She was gasping for any air she could get. Cromer just picked up her fourth.
Bailey Abbott on the line to shoot two for Rochester, looking to push this to a five or maybe even six-point lead.
I can't even begin to say enough about what Becky Malco has done in the second quarter defensively for the Lady Zebras against Cromer.
Abbott missed the first one. She'll have one more. 33 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by four. Parrott comes back into the game for the Lady Apaches. And coming out is Barden.
Malco has shadowed Cromer step for step the entire second half and limited her to five second half points.
Bailey.
She has really just taken her completely out of the offensive game.
Second for Abbott. In and out, back in. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 33 seconds to play in the regulation. Rochester leading 47-42. Marcus Mariota just won the Heisman thanks to Val from Rochester Sentinel vote.
You can read about who he voted for Monday.
That's right.
Sentinel.
There, Cromer gives off to Kristen Cromer with 25. Kristen Cromer across the timeline with 24, and she has the ball knocked out of bounds by Holland. With 24.9 to play in the game, Rochester by 5 at 47-42. It'll be Wabash basketball right in front of their own bench going to our left. Rochester has two timeouts, Wabash with three. Puckett in the corner against Abbott, who's had a fantastic basketball game, to clear Cromer. Cromer, leaner off the glass. Good! Timeout, Wabash. 17 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by three. It's a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Seconds of play in regulation. Rochester up 47-44. It'll be Lady Zebra basketball going to our right against the full court press.
Can you take care of the ball? Can you get it in, take care of it, and get to the free throw line? That's going to be the key.
Barkin will look to get it in. Allie looks. Timeout, Rochester. It'll be a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra basketball, 92.1 WROI. Seconds to play in regulation. Rochester down to their final timeout. They need to go the length of the floor against the full court press. Larkin will look to get it in again. Baseline left. Larkin slaps the basketball, sends things in motion, gets it into Malco. Malco runs away from the defense. Malco up the floor, cross the timeline with 12, and she is fouled hard. It is an intentional foul stone.
Yep.
An intentional foul on Wabash.
That
Rochester will shoot free throws and get the basketball back.
That was an easy call, and you hope that Malco is okay. She hit the ball, hit the floor pretty hard.
So Malco at the line to shoot two. 12.5 to play in the game. Rochester has two freebies and the basketball after the intentional foul on Stone.
Malco has got 13 points tonight. She's one of three from the free throw line.
Malco has two shots. Boy, Matt Stone didn't watch it. He's going to get teed up.
Yeah, he's been warned a couple times tonight.
Free throw for Becky is no good. She'll have one more. She's got to hit this one. 47-44. Rochester leads with 12 and a half to play in the game. Seconds, that is. Second for Becky is good this time. 48-44, Rochester by four. They've got the basketball on the far side.
Again, same scenario. Just get it in and hold on to it.
Larkin will look to get it in. Alley does to Malco in the corner. Malco loses the handle, picks the basketball back up to Larkin. Larkin dribbles away from the defense with seven, and she is fouled by Kristen Cromer with six, and she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Larkin has not scored at all tonight, so she'll be looking for her first point from the line. Again, the Lady Zebras with just four people scoring tonight, three of them in doubles.
Larkin's free throw is good.
Larkin makes it five in the book.
49-44, Rochester by five with 6 seconds to play in the game, and Puckett comes back into the game for Wabash. Larkin's second one No good. Rebound fought for. Puckett comes out of there with it. Offensive rebound to X for three. X dribbles out to the timeline with two. And that's going to do it. Rochester hangs on to win. 49-44. Post game show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.